in the clouds. She begs me to come down, says, boy, quit fooling around. I told her I love the view from up here. Warm sun and wind in my ear will watch the world from above as it turns to the rhythm of love. We may only have tonight, but till the morning sun, you're mine, all mine. Play the music low and sway to the rhythm of love.
Hi guys, Shannon Jorgensen here, day 3 of the 31-day challenge. I'm coming to you from my new chair. Yesterday I covered this with my mom for day 2. And I love it. I get to host from here now. So today I'm showing you a book I made my mom for Christmas. It's got a cool story behind it, so I'm going to tell you about that. And I'm also going to move on and show you how to make these little buttons. There's some little buttons I use in here. They're actually the kind that's on my hat, those little bubble fabric buttons. So I'm going to show how to do those. As far as the book goes, the story behind this is that my mom and I, she raised me in this little one-bedroom apartment until I was 18, and she stayed there another 5 years after that. So she was there for 23 years, and she just bought her, well, like 2 years ago, she just bought her new house, just for the first time, her first house. So really excited for her, and when she went to move out, we realized there were just so many memories there. We'd been there for so long. And so I photographed some little parts. I mean, there's a teapot and a chair and things like that, which for us are so many memories. And so every page in this book has a picture, a different part of the house. And then it also has a really big tag on it. And that's so periodically we can just go and she can write a memory in there as she thinks of it. So that's what this book is about. It's our old apartment that I was raised in with her. And yeah, so let me get started. I'll show you this and I'll go right into showing you the buttons. All right, guys, here's my Lorton book that I was telling you about. This is the one I made for my mom about our old apartment. Got a bunch of girly ribbons there, and these are vintage buttons. I didn't use any of the usual metal charms people do. These are some buttons I made. Some I made, some are from a paper pack. And my mother-in-law gave me a bunch of old antique buttons from her mom that I love. So that's what some of these are. That's what this is too. It was a black button and I just dry brushed it with some teal and gold. This is hot glue gun. I did those tiny beads and then a little button right here. So Velcroed this together. This is just velvet ribbon that you use for wrapping a gift. So the paper packs, I used quite a few paper packs. My two main ones. One is a K&Co Company, that's my all-time favorite paper pack. It's called Handmade. The other one is K&Co Company, and it's, Brenda Walker. Anyway, so this says Lorton Avenue, that's where we lived. Each page has a photograph, something simple about our house. So in this case, it has our mailbox that we had. And each page has a huge tag. Now, half of the tags are from this tag stack. I don't remember what it was called. It was an old one and these are just the leftovers, but they have lots of room for journaling so she can put different memories on there. The other half of the tags I made. Now you'll notice also on the edges there's something different. This edge here I have a few of those Tim Holtz alterations, you know, for the Sizzix die kind of thing that cut the edges. So that's what a lot of these edges are. There's four different ones that I have. Alright, let's open this up. Here's another page. That's a chair. This was kind of a funky tag. I tried something new, and that was the last time I did that, but whatever. I kept it. And here's another part of the house. They kind of went vertical. Didn't really mean for it to happen that way, but, you know, whatever. Little lace flower that I made. Just kind of crinkled up some lace and put a button in there. More tags. Here in this it comes out, shows the kitchen. It was a little old vintage type of kitchen. And here's, you know, this is kind of one of the tags I made from some of the paper from the Brenda Walter page. And they had some little flourishes, or not flourishes, little embellishments that went with it. Oh, here's another punch. If you see the edge of that, that's another punch that I have that does that edge. Here's this little soap container. It's just kind of memories for us. This is, you know, at Christmas, they have all those little flowers and leaves that you can put on top of packages. This is just one of those flowers. I inked it up a little bit. This under here is just one of those glitter leaves. I just layered all of it with a button. Here's another one, the teapot, like I was talking about earlier. Some more of those large tags. This is one that comes out. It's got this little set of pears. Came in the Brenda Walter thing. This was a page right here from Brenda Walter. It's a vase, and I just kind of, with my razor blade, I just cut out. I would just stick like some cardboard down in where the tag goes, and I would, with a pen, trace the outline of a leftover piece, like from here, you know, that was cut out, and just kind of cut it open so you could slide a tag in there. Here's more these kind of tags. This is a different one. This one is the Q Sarasara paper, which is, that's a really great stack. It's huge and has a lot of really great just kind of background papers. You know, when you want something colorful but you don't want a big pattern on there. Here's another page, more of this little bookshelf. She's just got a lot of really cool knickknacks and teapots and things that she's collected over the years. This was my grandma's, this tarragon blend, and I don't know. They just, a lot of these things for me have a lot of memories. This was the other half of our little kitchen. Let's see if you can see it. This is a great little flower pack that I got at Michael's. Some beads. Here is her windowsill. She kind of collected all these little animals you get from Cost Plus, World Market, with all the little legs hanging down. This was, again, you know, I did the razor blade idea right here. Let's try and get that back in. I don't know what's going on there. This was a fun page. It's just that ribbon like I have on the cover. Oops, and it came off. I gotta re-glue that. And these were some curtains I made her one year. It was one of my first times sewing, and I was really excited to try and make her some curtains that matched something that she had in her bathroom. She loved it, so that's what that is, and this slides right up here. Here's another one, did the razor blade technique, one of those fun buttons from that pack, and this slides out. This is a little J, her name's Joan, so J for Joan, she had that hanging from her lamp in her bedroom. See some of these tags. These are just little embellishments that came with the Brenda Walter. I don't even know if I'm saying that right. Walton. Sorry, Brenda Walton. I had to look at it. And so I just glued some of those on there. I tried to have some fun paper on the inside of each of these pockets too. Another big vintage button, just huge and funky. I love it. More of those little flowers. Another one of those flowers from that paper pack, or that little flower pack. It's another close-up of the mailbox right there. What is this? Oh, this is this side area. She kept her little firewood. There's all kinds of stuff to go with that. This is the neighbor's apartment. My grandma lived in there when I was growing up, in the next apartment over. So that's what that is. And this one, this is the neighbor one too as well. And then these are just some extra pages. I threw in some extra pages in there just because I know we're going to be adding to this book with lots of pictures we find along the way and memories and things like that. So that's my Lorton Avenue book for my mom.